Kenny Robskin here, and I just saw Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2. And it was pretty damn good. Very enjoyable fucking movie, but it's not quite as good as the original. You know? Yeah. But it might just be a case of the original Guardians of the Galaxy being a hard act to follow, right? I mean, I fucking love the original Guardians of the Galaxy. It's one of my favorite of the Marvel movies. So yeah, it is a really hard act to follow. You know? But, I mean, Guardians of the Galaxy has the right tone. It's a very, very funny movie. Action-packed, with a lot of heart, right? Just like the original. But, it's just not as good, you know? I mean, the main thrust of the movie is, Star-Lord finds out who his dad is. And, spoiler alert, I mean, it's not really much of a spoiler because they showed it in the trailer, but his dad is Kurt Russell, who is a being of incredible fucking power, right? He's got, like, cosmic powers and... And main part of the plot is, you know, about him, right? But the whole plot has a lot to do with family, you know, good and bad, right? Because Gamora, you know, the green chick, and her sister, the bald-headed blue chick, they're, like, fighting through the whole fucking movie. But, you know, they're eventually going to put their differences aside and, you know, team up, right? And there's some stuff with the blue guy, Yondu, right? Yeah, Yondu and the raccoon are hanging out. And really, Yondu steals the show. He really does. He's fucking great in this movie. We really get to see him use that whistle fucking arrow. And he does some amazing shit with it. And yeah, he totally steals the show. Right. But, I mean, it's kind of like Baby Groot in the movie. Cute little Baby Groot. Right. Actually doesn't steal the show as well as fucking original Groot. I really did like original Groot better. You know, Baby Groot, it like they tried too hard to make him cute, you know, in scenes that are supposed to be funny, but I don't think really work as well, you know. Well, you know, at the end of the original Guardians of the Galaxy, where there was that scene with Baby Groot in a pot, like, dancing, and then, like, Drax turns around and stops, right? That was so fucking cute in the fucking first movie, because little Baby Groot didn't want Drax to see him dancing. Well, they do a similar thing in Volume 2. Where he's dancing and, like, he doesn't want Drax to see him do it, but it's so aware of itself, you know? But, I mean, the first movie was kind of self-aware. It's just, I don't know, it brings more attention to it, you know? I mean, in Volume 2, they bring a lot more attention to its classic rock soundtrack, you know? Which is a nice collection of songs on the soundtrack. I really do like it, but... I don't know. It suffers from sequelitis in a way that most of the Marvel movies don't, you know? With a lot of the fucking Marvel movies, they seem to be getting better with the fucking sequels, you know? Captain America Winter Soldier was better than the fucking first Captain America, you know? I mean, that's not always the case, but... Well, it seems like the Guardians of the Galaxy 2 is not as good as the original. Which... I'm still fucking highly recommending it. It's still a fucking really good movie. You should definitely fucking see Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2. It's fucking good, right? But... Anyway, till fucking next time, keep it fucking real.
Is that a rifle?
You don't know what a rifle looks like?
It's just swords were your thing and guns were mine, but I guess we're both doing guns now. I just didn't know that.
What's that?
He says, welcome to the frickin' Guardians of the Galaxy. Only he didn't use frickin'.